out and route. Where... Why did I just turn around?
Can you close the door in there, please?
Getting into zone 2. Warm up. Getting ready for the climb. Testing my microphone. Well, so my goal today isn't to race or beat my fastest time. It's just to get through the route or an hour and try to get back in shape. If you Zwift, you know, feel free to add me as a friend and join me if you want to do a ride at the same time, or join the chat, ask some questions or make fun of me, whatever. That's what my wife likes to do. So if you're new to Zwifting, or most any exercise, especially cardio, and you're having trouble putting the watts down, one thing that I always recommend is creatine. That's my number one supplement. So here I'm doing the low watts with a higher RPM to just kind of get a good warm up before the climb starts. Here we go. This is a fresh installed Zwift, so I need to change my trainer difficulty to 100%. So the trainer difficulty setting, it doesn't necessarily change or make it less difficult or more difficult. I mean, it does in the sense that it works as a virtual set of gears. And you see, I'm riding a 1X gravel bike, so it forces me to put in a higher wattage in the climbs, but you're still putting in the same amount of wattage regardless of trainer difficulty to get up the hill. So in a sense it's more difficult, but you can essentially lower your RPM, but I prefer to keep it more realistic. My old FTP a few months ago was around 200 watts, but I can definitely feel it when I start getting close to that here. And if anyone's wondering, I've got a 42 in the front, so the gearing is pretty hot. And the good news, we're not having issues with the microphone today. That last feed was horrible. And again, if I was going for a PR, I would drop down the gears and I'd keep the watts high, but again, I'm just trying to make it to the top on this one. Use this as a time for higher RPM recovery. You can see I'm already 36 seconds behind my previous attempt. Got the Wahoo fan, the Wahoo headwind going almost full blast already. That's a sign of how out of shape I am. Let's see if there's any events we can get to. Nah. know, we got something special coming up at 9 or 10 o'clock in 40 minutes. And another question I hear people ask a lot in the groups, in the forums, is, you know, what do you eat before a cardio workout? I found that if I'm rowing or running, I try to eat as little as possible or nothing before my workout. With cycling, I can manage a banana, maybe an egg or two, and that gives me pretty good energy throughout the ride. Probably the biggest factor is not drinking alcohol or too much the day before or night before. That'll affect your performance probably the most. All right, and again, I leave it in the gear and do a higher RPM and try to get a little recovery here before we start the big climb. Surprised I'm only 42 seconds behind. My previous Epicom time. And again, it levels out here, and I'm going to use this as a chance to get my RPM up and try to do a little recovery. I'm only 3 seconds behind. Yeah, but the thing on a route like this with 500, 600, 700 plus meters in elevation climb, you know, not to rush it, take your breaks. It's not a race. Well, unless it is a race. And it's got my RPM off. So I just changed gears there for a minute. If you guys are watching, feel free to join the chat. Well, I'm also deciding to do this for several reasons. One of it is just to help motivate me to do my workout every day. But also, any of you that are watching thinking about trying Zwift. It's even got my wife in there on the treadmill instead of out here making ridiculous comments. Some of them on accident. Right? No, I think it sounds good.
Here's your coffee. Yeah, I can hear your topping.
That's okay. She just did 30 minutes or 20 minutes on the treadmill. So that's good. We've got that event coming up, but I think I might be finished when that thing starts. I'll be pretty tired. We're at 200 meters, probably another 250 left to go on the mountain route, Epic Com. Remember, my trainer difficulty is at 100%. And then my biggest gear, but still requires a lot of watts to keep going. Like I said, I'm running a 1X gravel bike with a 40 tooth in the front, and right now I'm in my 42 tooth sprocket. And that's at 100% trainer difficulty. For me, that's realistic. That's the only way to go. But when you're starting off, it doesn't really matter. As long as you're getting on the bike and doing your ride every day. And for anyone wondering, I'm riding a BMC Unrestricted Urs 01 Full Carbon with the SRAM Apex Group Set 1x11. Thank you. Starting to feel that burn in my calves. 226 meters. Probably another 250, 300 left to go. And again, I'll use this opportunity to bring up my RPM. Don't worry about the watts. And try to do the recovery. Get some of that lactate cleared out of the bloodstream. Anyone watching that does Zwift, if you want to, you know, ride with me or set up a group ride, just shoot me a DM and I'll schedule something. And in Zwift right now, I'm running the frame, the specialized Atheos S-Works, which works a lot better, but you can only unlock it around level 38 or 40, I'm not sure. And again, as this levels off, I'm just trying to raise up my RPM and do a little bit of recovery before the next segment of climbing. Get my heart rate down. The higher RPM, lower watts is really good for clearing out that lactate, which is causing the burns in your muscles. You just gotta keep going. So another reason why I choose cycling over the other sports or anything else is that I have asthma. And a lot of these VO2 max workouts that work to increase your VO2 max, they also are good if you have asthma, just in general, because if you can increase your thresholds and your limits, personally, I'm a lot less likely to have any kind of asthma attack. I don't think I've had a single one now in 2 years since I started Zwifting. Get it done. Yeah. So for anyone that's watching this for the first time, I'm going to be trying to do this at the same time most mornings. Not every morning, but you can look for me on the Zwift channel at this time of day, most days. And it's good motivation. We got the wife over there with the kettlebell. She doesn't want me to be in better shape than her. Get a lighter weight one then. And again, I'm going to use this opportunity to drop my RPM, lower my watts, try to get a little recovery for the next steeper grade climb. Well, we're only 4 seconds away from my PR from a month or two ago. It's not bad. Other than the extra weight up games. And for anyone watching this, and you're thinking about getting into Zwift, the price of the trainers have come down quite a bit. You don't need a $5,000 or $10,000 bicycle to get started. In fact, that's not recommended to use on a trainer. I got started with a bike that was around $500. And Zwift will give you a free 15-day trial, 14-day trial, I think. Or 25 kilometers, rather. And then after that, you have to subscribe. We've even gotten an account for my 4.5-year-old son and just a cheap Saurus mag trainer on a 16-inch Scott Rockster, and he loves it, and he's into BMX right now. But you know, he can do 10-20 kilometers on that thing on Zwift. 4.5 years old. Going faster than my previous time, which is very surprising. All right, now it's starting to get steeper. Slow down the cadence. Start push higher watts. That'll give you more of a muscular workout, less of a cardio workout. Alright, we're past halfway up this thing. Epic calm. And you can see my heart rate's relatively high. My max heart rate tops out about 187. Slow down a little more. I don't particularly enjoy riding in the 170s per minute for very long. Well, we're 17 seconds ahead of my previous time. Still pretty amazing, considering I haven't ridden in like 2 months. Also, I notice my hands start to hurt and fall asleep, but usually the more weight, the heavier I am, the worse it is. You got more weight pushing down on your palms. So I just try to shift my hand position every few minutes. If anyone wants to follow me or give me a ride on, just go to Zwift and you search for Game 4 Health. And that's me. Again, I'm going to use this time to do a little bit of higher RPM recovery. And for anyone wondering what kind of trainer, I'm running on a Wahoo Kicker version 5. This got over 12,000 kilometers on it. Still going. No problems. Yeah. Down we go. Again, I'm gonna raise the RPM, lower the wattage, try to get my heart rate down, and get ready for this final climb, top of the Epicom. My goal there will be to top out and finish at a max effort in the 180s, feet per minute. Alright. Final push. And it says 37 RPM, but it's probably double that. There we go. Alright, about 3 minutes to the top. And my ghost 8 meters behind me. And it's just like if you ever played Mario Kart. You got your ghost in your fastest time, so you know what to beat. Except this isn't my fastest time, just my previous best, I think, within the last 2 months. Except we don't get to throw shells at each other, just burritos. Alright, 500 meters left to climb in distance. Heart rate's getting up there. See if I can finish this. No, my ghost passed me. Maybe we can do it. Oh, there we go. I think we beat my previous best by 1 second. Maybe not even a whole second. Alright, I'm gonna skip the bonus climb, which is the radio tower, because for me, that's my hour. And I'm completely exhausted. You can see that I took my heart rate over my max, which I wouldn't normally recommend, but at least for less than a minute, it's just fine. Maybe good for you. Now, I always recommend trying to do a 10-minute cool down before you get off, so you don't get cramps. But I'm probably just going to do a few more minutes. So for anyone watching, my channel is Gain4Health. If you want to ride with me, just follow me on Zwift, or if you have any questions, send me a DM. We'll be saving all of our sessions to YouTube so they don't get tweeted out by Twitch later. And in the future, doing the group rides with me will be a subscribers-only feature. But for now, anybody can join me if you want. You see how quick the heart rate drops back down. Long, deep breaths. Go breathe in through your nose and out through your mouth. You can drop your heart rate a lot quicker. Alright, that's it for me for today. Catch you next time.